ever since I have always been saying, if only we are able to mobilize the potential of this country, channel it in right directions, make the Indian feel proud about the identity of being an Indian. You can imagine when I heard Dholakia ji speaking about Hanuman and willing to bare his chest and show that it is Ram and Sita who are there, how happy I feel. And it's persons like him or Dr. Linda or many among you. I'm very happy that you put a question of that kind. I'm very happy. Because I do Lord Dholakia's observation about NRIs rip their chest, there would be Ram and Sita seen there. India seen there. No, no, she said about suppose Muslims living in India. Muslim, Christians, that's all. I don't, the third is no community. All of us are secular. Muslims. Please, no, please, 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 please. She referred to the fact, and I don't blame her. The image that has been created in certain sections abroad, even in India, is that the present government is concerned about Hindus. It is not concerned about Muslims or Christians or other minorities. Let me say that there cannot be a more unfair image than this. Firstly, no, please, please, if you wait for a while, let me convey what I want to convey. It would be best. Rather than cheer me after any sentence, please don't. No, because this is an impression which even well-meaning people do have in their mind. I'm not blaming them. After all, every person, every party does, and particularly if he's been in public life for a long time, he does create an image. And that image, if it is wrong, it has to be corrected. I would only say, let's all recall the circumstances in which India became independent. The circumstances in which India, against the wishes of the Congress leadership of that time, Mahatma Gandhi, Pandit Nehru, Sardar Vallabh Bhai Patel, was partitioned. This happened in 1947. Many people were unhappy. Mahatma Gandhi would not stay for the Independence Day celebrations. He went away to Noakhal. And Pakistan was created. Pakistan declared itself a theocratic state, an Islamic state. The Constituent Assembly was meeting. And the Constituent Assembly completed its work in 1950. In 26 January, the first constitution of free India was adopted. And I would ask all of you, particularly the scholars, you go through the elaborate debates of the Constituent Assembly. No one advocated that because Pakistan has been created on the basis of the two-nation theory and it has declared itself an Islamic state, India is presently comprised of areas which have a Hindu majority, so let India become a Hindu state. No one even pleaded for that. And only recently I had occasion to speak on this subject in the Indian Parliament. I said, theocracy and a theocratic state is unacceptable to Indian tradition, to Indian history, to Indian culture. India can never be a theocratic state. India can never be a theocratic state, and this is what I emphasize even today. Of course, even in 1947, with leaders like Mahatma Gandhi and Pandit Nehru and Sardar Patel, we have seen the kind of killings that took place at that time. Horrible. I have been a resident of Sindh. I belong to Karachi. And in fact, I wanted to refer to the fact that it is not merely after independence that we have built up such a huge diaspora. We have Hari Leela here, sitting here, who has been, and many people from Sindh had gone abroad even in those times. And I remember very well that sometime when I first went to Hong Kong, I found that most of the people, Indians in Hong Kong, were from Sindh, were Sindhis. When I went recently to Spain, I found that most of the Indians in Madrid in Spain were from Sindh. So I'm familiar with that. But this also we must understand that India has been a secular country since a long time. It's part of a tradition and it will remain secular. If anything like what happened in Gujarat last year happens, it has happened in between these 55 years also, we feel sad, we feel ashamed, and we only say that it's an aberration. It must not be repeated. And I have again said, let's have it behind us. In India, the constitution guarantees and the history of the last 55 years guarantees that there shall be no discrimination against any citizens on ground of his faith, on grounds of his religion. And this is a commitment which the whole nation has made, and it is on that basis that we at this diaspora also try to include all from all, irrespective of faith, let them come here. In fact, I had occasion to visit Israel, and Israel told me they felt very happy that even when Jews were discriminated against in several countries, it was in India that never was any Jew discriminated against on grounds of his religion. This is the tradition of this country, and that tradition we hold dear, and we are proud of that tradition. We, at least speaking on behalf of the government, I can affirm and assure that this secularism is so embedded in our thinking that there can be no departure from that. Thank you.